In this video, I'll be helping you with the ALEKS problem type called finding the rate or time in a word problem on continuous exponential growth or decay. In this example, we have the mass of a radioactive substance that has continuous exponential decay at a rate of 7.6% per day, and we are looking for the half-life of this substance. And I'll start by recalling that for continuous exponential growth and decay, our formula is A equals A sub 0 e to the RT, where A is the amount after compounding, A 0 is the initial amount, E is our constant, R is the rate per unit time, and T is the amount of time for the compounding. And since we are looking for the half-life of the substance, we're looking for the time necessary for A, the final amount, to be one half of the initial amount. And what we can do here is do this substitution in. So rewriting, we have A, which is one half of the initial amount, is equal to the initial amount times E to the rate, which is 0.76. As a decimal, that would be 0.076. And since it's a decrease, this would be a negative rate times T. And T here is our unknown. That's what we're trying to find, how much time it takes for half of this substance to decay. But we can see that on both the left-hand side and the right-hand side, we have this A sub 0. And we can divide both sides by that A sub 0 to remove it from the equation altogether, which should make sense because the half-life of a substance doesn't matter how much we started off with, it just matters at what rate it is decaying. But we can now simplify this expression as 1 half equals E to the negative 0.076 T. And since the variable we are solving for is in the exponent, we can get it down out of the exponent by taking the logarithm of both sides. And since our base is E, we can take the natural log of both sides, giving us the ln of 1 half on the left-hand side. On the right-hand side, the ln of E to that exponent will cancel and leave us just the exponent. And now that we have the T out of the exponent, we can finish solving for T by just dividing both sides by that negative 0.076. This cancels on the right-hand side. And now that we have isolated the T, I can plug this expression on the left-hand side into a calculator like Desmos to make sure that there's no intermediate computations. And then rounding to the nearest hundredth, we have a 2 in the hundredths place with a 0 behind it, so it does not round up. Our time will be 9.12, and since our rate was in hours per day, our time is in days. So in 9.12 days, we will have half of what we had started with.